Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari, and I'm here to tell you about Ambermoon.net. And it's not this. For whatever reason, it's the name of the program. Ambermoon.net, you will not go to this address to get it. Although it's funny that maybe he's the creator of this. This Ambermoon version is looking to purchase this domain, perhaps. It's funny that they know that it's free. They're advertising free RPG games. But no, it's this one. Get rid of that one. Okay, so this is the website you can go to. I will put a link in the description. So for those who don't know, Ambermoon is an Amiga game from 1993 or 94. I just finished playing the entire thing. Someone by the name of Pyridicor, I don't know how to say it, sorry, has come out with his own version, which you do not need an Amiga or an emulator to play. It runs on Linux, Windows, Linux, and Mac, and it's basically, it's the game, identical, but is added in full screen mode, higher resolutions, music volume, cheat console, graphic filter, and auto derune function, which is, I wish I had that, because translating these runes is a pain. I think there was a lot more of them in Amber Star than Amber Moon, but so, right. So I'm just gonna show this off and download now. Put whatever price you want. I've already done so. And you can also go to development log. There's a site here. Project page on GitHub. Right. So you also download from here, the latest version if you like. So let me show you what you get once you download. Okay, so I assume you know how to download a zip file and extract it. So this is where I've extracted mine. It came in an ambermoon.net.zip, I believe, and I just made my own ambermoon.net folder. And it comes with a PDF. Congratulations. I'm only showing part of the screen now, so that's why it's looking like that. Map, which unfortunately is in German. You can find maps out there with the English names on them. But that's probably the one that originally came with the game. The patcher, I'm not sure what that is. I don't want to mess with it. Here's the runes. And there's a change log, readme, and actually a walkthrough as well, which I don't think has been made publicly available until Ambermoon.net started being released, because I don't remember ever seeing a walkthrough, and there's a FAQ, a FAQ out there, but a full-on walkthrough is bound to be very helpful. So anyway, you start the game. So there's the original in English and German, and then there's the advanced in English and German. Now the advanced is something he's still working on. He's like adding new features to the game, like to make creatures more vulnerable to elemental effects. Like if you use a fire spell on a certain creature, it would damage it more than if you use an ice-based spell and such. And I think that was true in the original game as well, but he's kind of heightening it and some other experimental stuff. So you want to see if you want to see what experimental stuff he's putting into the game. On the GitHub you can find all the information you want, and I'm sure the website as well that I showed you in the beginning. So here's the English. version. There's a Stein new quest. I'm not sure where the music is located. But anyway. Right. So this will be familiar to everybody. So to me, it really feels like I'm playing the Amiga version. Hold on one second. Okay. That should be a little easier to hear me. I'm not sure where the, options. Oh, nice. Okay, so you can actually change the resolution in here and change the volume. Okay, you click it and it goes in 10 increments of 10. Music on and off. I'm not gonna mess with the resolution in full screen because I got everything the way I like it. Graphic filter. Smooth, blur. Kinda looks like an old monitor with blur. Graphic overlay lines, grid. Oh, scan lines, okay. CRT, wow. Grayscale, sepia, that's interesting. And then what's this? Oh! Battle speed, default. Okay, and increase the percentage of the battle speed. So this is all quality of life stuff here. Show button tooltips on. Show stats tooltips on, off. Show runes as text. Okay, so the text will just show up and you can just read it. And you won't need the little rune table that I showed you before. Enable cheats. 3D floor and ceiling. This was in the original. None, floor, and then... I think it was ceiling not available. I think you had none, floor, or both. That's the way I think it was. Correct me if I'm wrong. Additional save slots. External music. Not sure. Not sure how external music would play through the game. Piratecore logo. Oh, so it doesn't play when you start the game. Thalion logo. Show save and load info. And then back to this. Very awesome. I like. Alright, there's our battle positions. We only have one member. Spellbook. We don't know any spells. Here's our Book of Arachnids. I've played this already, so... I know what all this stuff is. Oh, it's slow! I don't know if that's purposeful or not. The text actually scrolls as, like, slowly. Let me just look at it really quick. Yeah. Old damp cellars. Wow. Not going down there yet. Oops. With a bucket of water, you succeed in putting out the fire in the chimney. So, we can go in here. There's actually a good amount of things in here, if I remember correctly. More than one gold, but you can put all your stuff in here. That's the way I did it. More stuff than you can carry? Yeah, you play the game long enough, you will have more things than you can carry. Right, this one was locked, okay, and trapped. That it looked like something moved over there, something fly out of that chest. I remember a few other things being in here. I could be wrong. I mean, I'm trying to remember, 2 years ago I started playing this. So I'm going from that. I think there's some torches in one of these barrels. There's rations. So distribute food. So, okay, so now we have tool tips for these things. Nothing. I think this one's locked also? Nope. It's got a coil of rope and two lockpicks. Oh, and some gold. I don't remember this stuff being there. It looks like he's added additional, like, details here and there. Like pillows or something here. I don't remember that looking like that. But it could be because it's standing out more, because I have it on the brighter setting. Not the brighter, but I forget the way they put it. Right, the smooth graphic filter. Old sick man. I'm not gonna read all this because I read it before. This is new. I don't remember this part. Chandra said that the good side of our family is our strength, and he chose you to save Lyramion again. I don't remember it being quite this much text. Even death does not stop his influence. I believe that this is no normal dream, and I also believe that something terrible is happening. For this reason, I would ask you to take on this quest and find Chandra. Passageway to the cave in the northern mountains. I left my old armor. Remember that? You should bring with me the small piece of amber which Chandra gave me with the words, the eternal connection. I don't remember that. What words, eternal connection? Take a knife from the kitchen. I don't know if he said that either. Where's the knife? I'm assuming this is the kitchen. Here, maybe? Yeah, I remember that. The dagger is probably gonna do more damage than the knife. Rations. Alright, so what do we have? Oh, wow. What was that that showed up? Oh, nice! Look at that. He dies at the max age of 80. I didn't even know that. Character level. Attacks per round increase at specific levels. Ah! I had no idea. 12, 24, 36, and 48. That's pretty awesome. When they reach zero, the character dies. Spell learning points. Training points. Gold. Rations. Base value of damage and defense. That's awesome. So we can examine the item, we can look at the knife and see it does a damage plus 2, and then we can look at the dagger and see it does a damage plus 4. So give us the dagger, and we don't have any kind of shield or anything like that. So I don't know if this is dark down here, I forget. I think it is. We need a torch. We do need a torch. To burn through the web at the very least. I don't remember this text. When you reach the top of the cellar steps, you sense that same strange feeling you had as a child when you were asked to fetch something from the cellar for your grandfather. Just as you calm down again, you hear a creaking noise and then a high-pitched chirping which gradually fades into the distance. Yeah. We need a torch. Maybe in here. I often find them in barrels. That's why I keep looking in barrels. Ah! Our torches are here. Okay, good. Very good. The text didn't play again. I was waiting to see if it would. So that's good. Use torch. Wow! This is bright! This is really detailed. And it moves so smooth. Let's see. Now I'm using arrow keys. Ah! It would've been so easy to play like this. Look how smooth it scrolls. Nice. Well done. This is what I was really looking to see. The differences. There's a pond lizard, I believe, in there. There's a spider on the ground. It's not gonna fight me, right? It's not gonna attack. I don't usually see them on the ground unless they're the big ones. I'm so used to just playing it that way. Yeah, it's a little guy. Yeah, he doesn't fight. I'm missing my little monster eye that tells you when monsters are near. Here's one. Awesome. Well, we'll advance and move over. Oh. You gotta click again. Oh. I wonder if you can turn that off. You choose, and then it doesn't do it right. Yeah, big spider attacks Thalion. Yeah, I'm used to the game just continuing at this point. Usually I don't have to go click like that. It's just, it's a lot of clicking this way. Hopefully you can change that. That is cool, though. Battle speed default. Okay, how about plus 10? Let's see how that works. Oh, now it's going without the prompt, so now we don't have to click. There's the answer there. We're gonna fail a lot. It happens in the beginning. Everyone's just flailing at each other and missing wildly. Now, if you have a spell, you can find out a certain spell. You have to be a mystic, I believe, or ranger to find out how many hit points this thing has. And there's another spell to tell you, like, all the stats of it. Pretty awesome. 2 points of damage. Well, you've almost got me dead now. Okay. 20 experience. Now I would normally run back upstairs because it's going to run out my torch, but we have more torches and I'm not keeping this game, so I'm not going to play the whole thing over again. Sorry, guys. But we can camp. Oh, I don't... Yeah, we do have rations. Alright, so... It wouldn't take effect, so instead you wait 8 hours. The torch is burned out. Still didn't get back all my hit points either. I'm only down one hit point. Or life point, sorry. I'm not going to do all that again. Wait 8 hours and sleep 8 hours just to get 1 point back. Whoop. Oh! I ran into something. That was a nice fade effect, though. I didn't even know that something was there. Healing potion 1. Now we find it. We didn't even have to rest. Little did I know. Now, I think the healing potion 1 gives you back the amount of points for your level, like in, for instance, in this, it will give you 1 point back. If you're second level, it gives you 2 points. I think that's how it works. In any case, it's not a lot of money. That's not a lot of points. So. As you enter the cellar, you smell an appetizing odor. Large legs of ham and thick chunks of meat hang everywhere in the room. You can get them as rations. Getting flashbacks to 2 years ago. What about strafing over? Okay. It's actually faster to use the arrow keys. You can also use the arrows here and then turn like this. It's very awkward though. It takes a lot of getting used to. Turning is dodgy with it. And there's a map. This is the well with the cave lizard, or pond lizard, I believe it is. So, unfortunately, it doesn't yet tell us which way we're facing, but we are facing this way, or south at this point. It's so smooth. Have I been in here? Oh yeah. This is the same one. I didn't see the well from behind the pillar there. Are we facing west? Yes. Super smooth. I could tell, at least from the scrolling and everything, he's done a great job. And he's added text, which I'm not sure. Well, I think he has anyway. I don't remember the grandfather saying that much. But some purists might object to that. I don't mind. As long as it's written well, that's fine by me. Alright, so I wanted to see if I'm going south and around the corner, yeah. It's so fast. It's like I have an accelerator card attached already. You take a swipe at the spider's web and it rips with a sound as if it were made of fine silk. After you make a large enough opening, you hear excited chirping all around you. Excited! I'm excited to be chirping with you too. Alright, so we'll move over. Oh, wow. Why does the spider move that quick? He was here. How did he get here? That's an issue right there. Sorry. I'm poking holes in your game. Period decor. Your port, you say. I really have to watch that for the next one. I think maybe we'll fight one more spider and then we'll do our thing. So we're sitting here with 3 hit points. I'm not sure if these things hit for 3 hit points, but let's not take a chance. Party member will be self. Wow, didn't give you back that much. What did it give me back? 2 points? Yeah, 2 points. Oh well. Target remains. I just always think of you fighting something and, like, you don't know how much damage is left. It's just you attacked it and it's still there. Reminds me of Independence Day when they launch a nuclear warhead or something at the alien ship and there's a huge explosion and then all the fog clears. And the alien ship is still there, looking exactly brand new, all shiny the way it did. And the way that the pilot's voice was just like, "Target remains!" You know, he was just like freaking out. Yeah, target remains. Ooh! Yeah. I didn't remain. He did 6 points of damage. That's the answer to that. He can do a lot more than 3 points. Yeah, because I never saved, so. But anyway, that is your tiny little sneak peek at Ambermoon.net. If you guys want to download it, try it out for yourselves. See the link in the video description. And yeah, I'm interested to see where he goes with this and what other new features get added. Pretty good amount of effects there. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play, and always, seek adventure.